Hello friends, welcome to my channel Enthusiastic Learner. Continuing with chapter 2, part 5, today we are going to discuss about industry. We have already seen that there was heavy dependence on agriculture for employment. About 65% of the population were dependent on agriculture for their livelihood. But the income earned from agriculture was very low. That is, the GDP the nation earned from agriculture was very low, leading to low national income and low per capita income. The need of that time, that is between 1950 to 1990, was development of industry. Economists have found that poor nations need to expand the industrial sector for development. Looking at the developed countries, we see that they are heavily dependent on the industrial sector and service sector for employment. Let's take example of America. The total employment the agriculture sector gives to the population is only 1%. And that is the reason for their prosperity. Industry provides stable employment, promotes modernization and overall prosperity. At the time of independence in India, industry was confined only to cotton textile industry. There were only two well-managed iron and steel industry, one at Jamshedpur and other at Kolkata. And so that time it was very important to have a well-developed industrial base in the country. Need of the time was distribution of industry, variety of industry in all the regions of the country. Under this scenario, the public sector and the state played a major role in controlling and commanding the economy of the country. The private industrialists were not interested to invest their money as the market was not very big. And the second most important reason is that the government wanted equal distribution and variety of industry in all the regions of the country. The state played a major role in controlling the economy of the country till 1990. This meant that those industries which were important for the economy, the government would have complete control. The policies of the private sector had to be complementary to that of the public sector. As the goal of the government was to command the economy, so industrial policy resolution of 1956 was adopted. The main features of the resolution was that the industries were categorized into three categories. The first category of industry was exclusively owned by the state. The second category was the industries in which private sector could supplement the efforts of the state sector, but with the state taking the sole and whole responsibility for starting new units. The third category consisted of industries in the private sector. Although there was the category of private sector industry, but it was under strict control of the state under the policy of licenses. With this policy, the government tried to develop the economically backward regions. Private industries were given licenses and some concessions to establish industry in the economically backward regions, like tax benefits and lower rate of electricity. In 1955, the Village and Small Scale Industries Committee, also called Carve Committee, was set up. Small scale industry is very important for the generation of job employment because small scale industry is labor extensive. It cannot compete with the big industry, but it plays a very important role in the economy. The small scale industry is defined by the maximum amount of money invested in the unit. In 1955, it was 5 lakhs rupees, but today it is 1 crore for the service sector and 5 crore for the industrial sector. This small small-scale industry being labor extensive was very important, so it required to be protected by the government. Government announced certain products to be produced under small-scale industry. The industrialists of small-scale industry were given certain concessions like lower excise duty, the bank loans at low rate of interest, etc. Thank you, friends, for watching my video. I hope you liked the video. Please do comment.